In this video, we're going to talk about the additional customization features when you're customizing your invoice template. All right, so I have my invoice pulled up here, and it can be any invoice, and I'm going to go ahead and click Customize. And then I choose Customize Data Layout because I'm only customizing this one form right now. So it pulls up already in the additional customization area. The basic customization and the layout designer are both shown in a different video. So in this, first of all, the first thing I noticed is that I have here copy of Intuit product invoice. That's the name of this invoice template right now. But I want to change that. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel out of here and go into my templates list. And I'm going to edit this template and manage templates. And here it'll let me customize this title. So my company invoice. Okay. So now when I'm on the invoice template that I'm going to be using, right here instead of saying copy of, it says my company invoice. So then we're going to go ahead back in here to the customization. So they have all these different tabs, and we're going to go through each one. This is the header tab. This decides what boxes up top here show up on your invoice. Do you want the title to show up there? Do you want it to be on the screen, or do you want it to be printed only when you print it? Being on the screen, I think, is pretty smart there, so you know which template you're in. Do you want the date to show up? Invoice number. Do you not want it to say invoice number? Maybe you want it to say work order and work order number. So I see now that change is right there. Work order number. Okay. It's giving me all these warnings telling me that I can change the space in the layout designer. So if I need to widen that for some reason. Do you want the bill to address to show up? Do you ship anything? If not, you probably want to take this. See, it's telling me about overlapping fields. It's just warning me that I can change things in the layout designer. So I don't want the ship to address in there. Do I want the customer's PO number showing up? Yes, that's a good idea. Do I want the sales order number showing up? Maybe that's an internal sales order number thing. So I just want it to show up on our, when we see it on our screen. But I don't want it to print for the customer, okay? So notice how it doesn't change anything on this work order. Now it's called a work order. But it would add it, once I save it, to these boxes here. All right? I'm actually going to change this back to invoice so it's less confusing. Then you have here your terms. Do you want the terms to be on the screen? Do you want them to be printed? That's probably a good idea for both because you want to make sure your customers are paying within their terms. If you have a due date requirement, if you have a sales rep might be an internal thing only. So I'm going to take this, uncheck it, and it comes off of my screen for my headers here. Do you want the customer account number to be shown? Yes or no? Do you want the ship date? I don't really need the ship date. Let's just pretend. Ship via, I don't need that. And the FOB, freight on board, I don't need that. I also don't do jobs, so I don't need that. So notice how it already takes away a whole bunch of the header boxes here. Now in a different video, we can talk about the layout designer and how to move these things around. All right, I'm gonna go on to my columns now. Oh, I'm sorry, first I wanted to mention, there's this other box here. This other box is not a searchable field. You can add a box and name it whatever you want and have it free type. But I would recommend watching the video on creating custom fields in customers and in items. The reason for that is, again, this is not a filterable or searchable field, and you want to be able to search for things in that field. That's the whole point of it. So I would recommend not using this other box and using a custom field. So watch that custom field video. Okay. We're going to go ahead to the columns. Now the columns are these drop downs here. All right. So you have here your item. We want to show that. The description. Maybe you don't want the item code to print though. You just want the description to print. the quantity, the rate, amount. And again, here's those two other fields, but if you really are going to use custom columns, I would use the custom column in the items list rather than using it here. And I'll show you again how that works in another video. What order do you want these in? If you don't want quantity first, you want item first. I'm going to put this as number one, say continue. On here, it doesn't change because we're not showing the item screen in here, but on this invoice form here, it'll change once we save it. Okay. Then we're going to go ahead to the progressive columns. If you do progress invoicing, then you can go ahead and have these additional columns. Previously invoiced amount, you want to show that on the screen, how much has been back, is on back order, how many have been ordered. So if you do ship partial shipments, it's a good idea to add these to your screens. Okay, but I'm not going to add them for now. Your footer, so down here, do you want to have a customer message box? Yes or no? Do you want a subtotal box? Okay, subtotal sales stacks underneath the subtotal. And again, we can go into the layout designer in the next video and we're going to arrange these so that it looks a little bit better than that. If you want to know which payments and credits have been applied, the balance due, the customer total balance on the bottom down here, the job total balance, and if you want to have a long disclaimer here, this is great for lawyers or, for example, if you sell software that's licensed to you, you can have a little disclaimer down here. And then do you want them to be able to pay using the Intuit payment network, yes or no? And we go into that in another video. Then there are the print choices over here. Do you want to use the printer settings from your printer setup, so meaning your Windows printer settings? Do you want to specify settings down here? So maybe you set up your invoice to be landscape. Maybe every time you print an invoice, you want to print two copies of it, one for your internal, one to send out to the customer. Do you want to print page numbers on your invoices? Do you want to print trailing zeros? Okay, so there's a whole bunch of different choices that you can have separate from just your Windows printer setup. All right. So that's the additional customization. But now in the next video, we're going to talk about the layout designer, and that's where the real fun happens.